Three, four. Shut the door. Five, six. Pick up sticks.
What?
Seven, eight. Lay them straight. Nine, ten. A big fat hen.
Do it again.
11, 12.
Noah smells.
11, 12.
Noah smells.
I'm not sure. Sorry. So we got tonight. Hey, can you hit mute on these two mics? They're channel 2 and 4,
I believe. Thank you. All right. Hey, we are excited that you guys are here tonight. We are jacked. We have an awesome night tonight. And we're talking again about New Year's fears. All right? New Year fear, 2016. I know we're all in different places in our lives. And so I asked Alex several months ago, right? It's been several months ago. Alex came to me and said, we're talking about using our gifts and talents. He said, hey, I would like to write short stories. And I want to use that talent and that gift to help the youth group. And I'm like, all right, cool. Never thought about that before, but let's think about it. And so we were talking about this series or this lesson, this one night lesson. And he said, I think I can come up with an awesome story. So he thought about it and was working on like two or three different ones. And I said, send them to me, man. I want to see what they are. And he's like, nah, they're not right yet and whatever. Well, he got one just right. It fits in perfect where God wants to take us tonight. So I'm going to ask Alex to come and read his story. What's the title, bro? Do you have a title for it? What is it?
Apocalypsis.
All right. He's going to give us, this is a fiction story, right? This is a fiction story based on the book of Revelation. All right? So, give Alex
sci-fi. Does he get the microphone?
I got it. It was regular school day in April. Everybody was getting giddy since the end of the school year was a month and a half away. All the snow from the week winter had long melted, and spring had sprung, with all of its stormy fury that commonly accompanied it. Spring storms thundered across the sky. The day was going to be a rainy one. I'm getting sick of the spring, I thought to myself. We've had a lot of this lately. The new president, who won the polls by with a whopping 94% lead, was to make a speech of all the flying that was occurring. One strange thing that night was that the clouds were clear, leaving a harvest moon that was nearly the color of blood. We thought it would be from the spring pollen. This has been happening for about 2 weeks now. There was also a massive earthquake out in the San Andreas Fault, that measured 9.2 on the Richter. We felt tremors all the way over here in Ohio. Los Angeles was completely leveled. As a result, people everywhere panicked. They cried out, "Woe is humanity, the end is nigh." Nobody will believe them. They should have, though. We all should have. I was sitting in my third period trigonometry class, and my teacher was droning on about something I had no clue about, and frankly, I didn't care about either. A few minutes after my teacher was done talking, we began to work on homework. I was going to lean over and ask for the answers for the homework from the girl beside me, but she had disappeared. I looked around, didn't see her, and noticed that the other students, as well as the teacher, were gone too. Not a single student had squeaked out when they had disappeared. All the personal belongings were still there. The only thing missing was, well, themselves. There were a few other students in the class, and they were just as dumbfounded as me. I got up peeked into the hallway. There were students from the other classes that had also stepped out into the hallway, looking for where the peers had disappeared to. Where on earth is happening? This can't be right. People just can't disappear, I thought to myself. I was never much of a Christian. Yeah, I went to church and all that, but I never paid attention there. I could never believe a story about a long-haired hippie that healed people and woke from the dead. Most of the people that went to the church anyways had gone nuts. I wouldn't be surprised if the folks in the white suit ship hauled them away. But now I'm beginning to question myself. But surely people can't have a mass hallucination. This has to be real. Now I went up to someone a guy I knew decently well. I talked to him in the halls every once in a while. He was a nice fellow. What's happening? Where is everybody? I asked. Not a clue, he replied. This is really weird. What do you think they went off to? I said. I don't know. They couldn't disappear that fast. Do you think it's aliens or something like that? We both stepped out into the open area in front of the school auditorium where several others were gathered. There was a little murmuring and a sense of fear floated in the air. It felt like there was a cannonball sitting in my gut. After waiting around for a while, people got really antsy. So as a result, some of the more curious people decided to go outside and see what happened there. As I exited with them, I saw that the school wasn't the only place affected by random disappearances. A lawn carriage tore a crashing telephone pole, causing it to be knocked over into a menacing angle, only being held up by the lines that were hooked to it. Smoke had arisen from downtown, and the bridge was a mess from driverless cars that crashed into each other. What was scary was that there were no sirens. Nobody could or would react to the situation. Some time had passed, and chaos erupted. With no law enforcement, or anyone for that matter, keeping things in check, things as well as morals went downhill fast. Chaos in its rawest form was unleashed. The first chaos that plagued us well was the plague itself. I had awoken one morning covered in sores all over my body. I had seen pictures of this before in history class. It was the bubonic plague, the Black Death. The pain was intense. I had a raging fever. But by some strange incident, 3 days later, I had gotten over it. A day after I had gotten over the illness, I went into the kitchen sink to get myself a glass of water. I grabbed a glass and turned on the faucet. The water that came out was thick and red, red as blood. "What on earth?" I yelled. I tossed the glass into the sink out of surprise. This can't be rust. That's more of a reddish brown. This was a sickly shade of red. Some hours later, I became very thirsty, so I decided to go for it again. It was still blood red, but desperate times call for desperate measures. I took a sip, and it tasted bitter and awful. No red knew drinkable. A sour aftertaste stuck in me with me for 3 hours. Later on, since the news channels were down, I decided to go outside to see how the weather was like. When I stepped out onto the front porch, the heat was like being tossed into a furnace. I stepped onto the pavement, where the soles of my shoes became soft and began to melt, leaving a trail of rubber footprints. I looked up to the sun, and it was not its usual circular form. Outstretched from its center was a great arm of fire. The sun was dying at a far faster pace than ever could be predicted. How could this be? This is impossible, I thought to myself. This keeps getting worse and worse. 2 weeks the sun was like this, until one night, when the sun was lighting up the other side of the planet, it had lost its spark. The earth was engulfed in darkness, but that was soon different as the looters and thieves came out of the dark holes and set fire to what they could. The light had shown itself again, but in the burning of man's creations. The water had disappeared along with the sun, but up above, there was a mighty rumble of thunder as static lightning arched across the sky. In this moment of chaos, I realized the meaning behind this. It was the last stand of humanity, and humanity had lost. In that moment, I thought to myself, is there a God? Where is he? As I see the demons of the night in the dance of death, I realized in that moment that God was alive and I was one of the forsaken. After seeing this haunt of a town, all ablaze, I now knew what it all meant. How else could all this happen? As I looked towards the sky, as I looked towards the ground, I saw an immense shadow move across it. I looked up and saw a dark mass move above the clouds, and which were illuminated by the great fires miles away. Then it peaked its head. It was a mighty serpent. Upon it, a being was on its back. After that, everything turned dark. And that was that. I could not hear. I could not see. I could not feel. There was complete and utter nothingness. This is hell.
Oh, good job.
Good story.
Yeah.
That's going to set the stage for tonight. And we're going to talk about what Alex just wrote about. And that's kind of scary if you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
What's that going to be like? What's it going to feel like? What's going to really happen? Can we be afraid? Do we have to be afraid? We're going to dive deeper in that tonight. But I want to invite you guys to stay with me. Sophie and Olivia are going to come and they're going to worship with us tonight. And guys, if you're uncomfortable with this, it's all fine. We're all at different stages in our walk. Some of us are here for the candy. Some of us are here for the good-looking girls. Some of us are afraid of good-looking girls. We have a phobia. It's all good. All right. I'm going to encourage you guys to, if you're not comfortable singing, that's cool. I'm going to encourage you to listen to the words, read the words, and think about your life and where you're at today. Okay? So we're going to sing two songs, and we'll jump into the lesson tonight. All right? Sound good? All right, I'm going to pray for us first. Father God, Lord, we thank you for tonight. We thank you for the opportunity to come and worship you, Lord. We thank you for for the amazing gift that you've given Alex to write the story, Lord, to have us question. What's this going to be like, Father? What's the end of the world going to be like? When is the end of the world? Do we have to be afraid? Is there anything to fear? Father, we're all at different places in our lives tonight, so Lord, I just pray you just fill this place with your Spirit, Lord. Calm our hearts, calm our fears. And Lord, as we sing songs of praise and worship to you, Lord, may the words penetrate our hearts and meet us where we're at tonight, Lord. May we praise you tonight for all that you've done and all that you're going to do. Lord, we love you. We thank you for this opportunity. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not afraid to die. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am.
Chosen me, Lord, I
child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God.
Amen. Woo-hoo!
Father God, we thank you, Lord, that we don't have to be afraid of tomorrow. We don't have to be afraid of what our future holds, because we are your children. And your word promises us that you love us, and you have plans to give us a hope and a future. So Lord, tonight, just open our hearts, open our minds to the words that you have for us tonight, Lord. We thank you that we can come and worship you tonight. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, guys, grab a seat.